Hello guys, welcome back to YSHIS YouTube channel, and this is Pooja Sharma. So I'm back with our biosphere reserves. So today we will be reading about the next two biosphere reserves. So before we begin with the video, as you all know, this is the WhatsApp detail of YSHIS. You can contact on this number for your enrollment details or for any UPSC related queries. You can even email us and visit our YouTube channel. There are a lot of mini series going on which will help you for your prelims, and it will be like a revision for you. So let's start. So first we have the Achanakmar and the Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve. So the Achanakmar and the Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve, it is a biosphere reserve which is in India. It extends across two states, that is Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, and it covers a total area of 383,551 hectares. This reserve, it is located in the northern part of the Biogeographic Zone 6 and the Biogeographical Province 6A, which is the Deccan Peninsula and the Central Highlands. So we were reading about these biogeographic zones in Shankar IAS environment series, which are going on parallelly. So please try to connect both the information. So about 68.1% of this reserve, it lies in the Bilaspur district in Chhattisgarh, and the other major portions of the reserve are in the Anuppur and the Dindori districts of Madhya Pradesh. So the protected area of the Achanakmar Wildlife Sanctuary, it is located in the Bilaspur district within the Biosphere Reserve. Then we have the geography. So this Achanakmar and the Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve, the ID, it is divided into core buffer and the transition zones. So the core zone of 551.55 kilometer square, it is in Chhattisgarh, and the Amarkantak Wildlife Sanctuary is in the core zone. So as you can see over here, this is Bilaspur district. Then we have Dindori district over here and the Anuppur district. So you can see the proportion. So the buffer zone and the transition zone is of 3,284.36 kilometer square, and the buffer zone, it is spread across the two states. So an area of 1,224.98 kilometer square, it lies in the Madhya Pradesh district. Madhya Pradesh state, and the remaining area of 2,059.38 kilometer square is in Chhattisgarh. So you can see this blue portion and then this green portion over here. So the topography of the biosphere reserve, it varies from the lowland rice fields, which is in Bilaspur district, and the Anuppur district, and the wheat fields in the Dindori, to the hills of Michael range and the Michael range of the Satpuras. So the topography of the soil over here, it is bauxite rocks and several streams and nalas. Nalas are nothing but drainage. So they flow through the reserve, and many of which they are not perennial. So the area of the Achanakmar and the Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve, it is considered to be one of the major watersheds of peninsular India. And it separates the rivers that drain into Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. And also the reserve is also the source of three major river systems, that is the Son River, Johila and the Narmada River. So the Michael Hill ranges, together with the Vindhya and the Satpura, they lie within the Achanakmar Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve. This Vindhya and Satpura range, they are important from the perspective of the Narmada and the Tapi Rift Valley. So then the climate over here. So the typical monsoon climate of the reserve has three distinct seasons, that is summer, which takes place in March and June. Then we have rainy in July and October. And then in November and February, we see winter. So the months of May and June, they are generally the hottest in the reserve. And the coolest months are December and January. So the southwestern monsoon winds, they'll bring rainfall to the area during the months of June to September. Then the flora. So the natural vegetation in this biosphere reserve, that is Achanakmar Bilaspur Biosphere Reserve, it varies across the reserve. So the forest area of the reserve, it has a tropical deciduous vegetation, and it can be classified into the northern tropical moist deciduous and the southern dry mixed deciduous forest. So moist is in the sense it will be wet over here, there will be wet deciduous trees, and over here it will be a mixture of both wet and dry. So the reserve is quite rich in plant diversity. It is having a combination of different climatic and edaphic conditions. As I told earlier, edaphic means soil conditions, okay? So, soil conditions at various altitudes, and the region provides shelter to various thallophytes, biophytes, and then pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperm species, which we have already learnt about in the previous videos. So, almost 1,500 plant species, which represent over 151 plant families, can be found over here. And several angiosperm species, they are found in this Achanakmar and Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve. So many planted gymnosperms, they have been localized in Amarkantak Plateau, and they have also adapted to the local environmental conditions of the area, and some of them are considered as endemic species. So apart from these, more than 105 species of medicinal plants, they are found over here, and 25 of the species which are found over here, they are considered as rare. So as you can see in the picture, it says as that illegal wild bamboo mushroom collection in this reserve happens during the rainy season. Then we have the fauna. So the faunal composition of Achanakmar and Amarkantak Biosphere Reserve is quite rich. So more diverse and flourishing populations of the wildlife, it can be found in Achanakmar Sanctuary than in any other reserve forest area, including the Biosphere Reserve. So the main reason for this is the better protection and also the improved habitat conditions in the sanctuary, and also the strict conservation actions which have been taken over here. So according to the 2004 census, the Achanakmar Sanctuary, it is a home to 26 tigers, 1,936 cheetahs, 28 bears, 46 panthers, then 1,369 sambar deers, then we have 376 barking deers, and 552 bisons or the gore. So you can see they are in order over here: tiger, panther, we have bears, then we have the cheetahs, and then the sambar and the barking deers over here, and this is the bison. So other important fauna species found in the reserve, they include the black buck, chinkara, then we have wolves, foxes, jackals, then we have wild boar, monkeys, and giant squirrels. Also, besides the rich variety of mammal fauna species, the reserve also has a natural habitat to 170 bird species, which are belonging to 51 families, and more than 30 species of snakes and lizards, along with several species of frogs, like we have the cricket frog, then we have the burrowing frog, then we have tree frog, ornate narrow mouth frog, toad, and the bullfrog. So they are found in this reserve as well. Also, we will see there are four varieties of monkeys which are found over here, which is the langur, then we have the red face monkey, then we have the red hip monkey, and the normal Indian monkey. Okay, the next one is the Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve. So the Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve, it encompasses a large part, which is up to 85% of the island of the Great Nicobar, and the largest of the Nicobar Islands in the Indian Union Territory of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So as you can see over here, so the Nicobar lies in the Bay of Bengal, which is present in eastern Indian Ocean, and 190 kilometers to the north of the Indonesian island of Sumatra. So the reserve has a total core area of approximately 885 kilometer square, and it is surrounded by a 12 kilometer wide forest buffer zone. So in the year 2013, it was included in the list of the Man and Biosphere program of the UNESCO to promote sustainable development, which is based on local community effort and the sound science which takes place over here. and the reserve was declared. It was declared as a reserve in 2013 January. So it incorporates two national parks of India, which were gazetted in 1992. So that is the larger Campbell Bay National Park, which is over here, as you can see, and which is in the northern part of the island. And then we have the Galathea National Park in the southern interiors over here. So the non-biosphere portions of the island, they are set aside for different activities like agriculture, forestry and settlements. And they are confined to the southern, western and the southeastern coastal regions. As you can see, this green area is our Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve. And this grey region, which you can see, this is the settlements, forestry and agricultural portion or region. So the reserve has a total area of 1,03,870 hectares. And the core area of 53,623 hectares, it comprises of the Campbell Bay and the Galathea National Parks. So a buffer area of 34,877 hectares includes forested lands adjacent to and between the two parks. So between the two parks, all the forest land. So there is also a transitional area of 10,070 hectares, which includes 5,300 marine hectares. So there is a portion reserved for marine species also. So the environment is classified by the World Wide Fund for Nature as tropical and subtropical broadleaf forest biome, because as we know that it is closer to the equator and it is located in the Indo-Malayan realm. So again, you can connect this also with Shankar IAS. We were reading it about the Indo-Malayan realm and also about the biogeographic zones, which I was telling in the previous slide. So the reserve is a home to many species of plants and animals, often endemic to Andaman and Nicobar Islands biogeographic region. So the species of fauna in the reserve, it includes the Nicobar scrub fowl, which is over here, which is a megapod bird. Then we have the edible nest swiftlet. Then we have the Nicobar long-tailed macaque. And then the saltwater crocodile, monitor lizard, Andaman water monitor lizard. Then we have the great giant leatherback sea turtle. Then we have the Malayan box turtle, which is over here. Then we have the Nicobar tree shoe, which is this one. And then we have the reticulated python. And also the giant robber crab or the coconut crab. So I think this is the last slide, and this is telling us about the tribes. So the Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve also incorporates territories and traditional lands of the indigenous Nicobarese people and the Champaign people. So these are the Nicobarese people and these are the Champaign peoples. So that's all for today. I think we are done with. So I'll be back with the next biosphere reserves. Till then, make sure that you're liking our videos and then sharing them with everyone, whoever is preparing for, you know, UPSC and government exams. And also make sure that you comment in our comment section below and also subscribe to our channel so that in the upcoming days, all the videos which we upload, you will have access to them. And also the mini series which are going on now parallelly, they are very important for your prelims perspective. So make sure that you watch them. They are short videos only, so it won't take too much of your time. So these are the details of Vaishayas. You can, as I said earlier, you can contact on this number. You can even email us and visit our YouTube channel. So until next time, all the best and thank you so much.